And look around for the true scholars of Islam and the true awliya of this ummah. The true scholars of Islam and the true awliya of this ummah. Is that clear? Things don't come cheap. You will have to travel. People travel for the dunya. Why can't we travel to meet the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? People travel for the dunya. Why can't we travel to be in the presence of the true ulama of this religion? Why? And we heard that the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they would travel from Medina to Munawwara all the way to Egypt just to take one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They would travel from Medina to Munawwara all the way to the lands of Sham just to receive one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Go out of your way and search for these true awliya, and you will see that when you see them, you'll be thrown back. When you see them, you won't be able to speak. When you see them, you'll become humbled instantly. You'll become humbled instantly. Why? Due to this awe-striking majesty that Allah Azza wa Jal has covered them with. Is that clear? So, Shaykh Muhammad Al-Fahhan mentioned an important point. He said, even though he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had so much beauty, never was a single woman from the Sahaba put into fitna due to that beauty of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is extremely important. Is that clear? This is extremely important. One day I was in Damascus by the old railway station. By the old railway station in Damascus City. Muhammad Ansar, have you been to Damascus? Have you seen the old railway station? No. Okay. That was the railway station that Sultan Abdul Hamid made from Damascus to Madinatul Munawwara one way, and the other side was to Istanbul. Anyway, in front of the railway station, there was a money exchange. I was exchanging some money one day. I exchanged my money and I came out. And I saw the Muhaddis of Sham, Sheikh Nuruddin Itar, walking past the money exchange, right? I came out of the door, the money exchange, and I saw him walking past the money exchange. And I was just, it was as if an electric shock went through me and I couldn't move. Right, I couldn't move. And then I wanted to approach him and give him salam, but I couldn't move, I just stood in my place. And then the Shaykh walked past, and then I turned towards his direction of walking and I just watched him walk. And subhanAllah, you know his walk? He wasn't even picking his feet up from the ground. He was scraping his feet on the ground, right? Just like this. And he did not raise his blessed sight from the ground. I was watching him and observing him. He did not pick his head up from the ground, and nor did he pick up his foot. He was walking like this, in such humbleness. The greatest scholar of hadith of the land of Sham. Just to know about him, I'll tell you, when I was in Damascus, he had 28 female students who had memorized Bukhari and Muslim. That was when I was in Damascus. He had 28 female students who had memorized the whole of Sahih al-Bukhari and the whole of Sahih Muslim. Someone came to him and said, Sayyidi, give me an ijazah in hadith. The Shaykh said, what have you memorized? He said, nothing. He said, you haven't even memorized Riyadhus Salihin, what are you asking an ijazah for? It doesn't make sense. You know, and something we used to read in the books that I saw in Shaykh Nuruddin Itar, especially, it's in other scholars too, but the way I saw it in him, it was amazing. Shaykh Nuruddin Itar, he used to have a lesson of hadith every Friday evening between Maghrib and Isha in a masjid known as Jami' al-Shamsiyya. Jami' al-Shamsiyya in an area in Damascus called Muhajirin, right? And he would teach from his own commentary on a book by Imam Ibn Hajar Asqalani radiallahu anhu. Imam Ibn Hajar has a book known as Bulugh al-Maram fi Ahadith al-Ahkam. بلوغ المرام في أحاديث الأحكام. This particular book of hadith deals with all of the sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam concerning matters of worship and matters of ibadah. Is that clear? Sheikh Nuruddin Itar has wrote a commentary on that book in about 2 or 3 volumes, if I am right, known as إعلام الأنام شرح بلوغ المرام. He used to teach his own book, and believe me, every time the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's name was mentioned, his eyes would close and become tearful, right? And he would lower his eyes, and then it would take a few seconds before he would reopen his eyes. Now imagine this, he was teaching through a book of hadith, and in a book of hadith, in every line, so many times the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes, and every time this was his state. And I would sit and observe this from him. That, you know, his eyes would become tearful and they would close, and the way he would say, Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You could see how connected these people were with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this particular maziyah, this particular speciality, I saw it in one scholar before him many years ago. And I was really attracted to that scholar just because of this one thing. I remember I was a little boy and one of my teachers took me to a talk. And I can't remember understanding anything of that particular talk because I was quite young. Except that I noted one thing about the speaker. That every time he mentioned the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he would say sallallahu alaihi wasallam like this. And I was a young boy and I thought that was so beautiful, and I had never heard it like that ever before. That someone saying it so nicely and so calmly. So Shaykh Nuruddin Itar, I was just stopped. I couldn't even give him salam. And he just walked past. The greatest scholar of hadith of Sham, he walked past and you can't even give him salam. Why? Because of this awe-inspiring majesty that he had. Is that clear? This was one time. There was another time I also saw him walking up a bridge in Damascus, outside the University of Damascus where he used to teach. Again, this time I gave the salam, the Shaykh salam, but that's all I could do. Just give him salam and move on. Why? Because the awe-inspiring majesty is so much that you can't hang around, you can't stick around, it's too much, it's too overwhelming, it's unbearable. Is that clear? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was covered.